Hey guys, Led here. Today we're smoking meatloaf on the Pit Boss. I'm gonna take you inside the house and show you what I put in it, then we'll get back out here on the grill and get this thing burning. Stay tuned. All right guys, so here's the ingredients for this here meatloaf. I've got a good pound of ground beef, some ground chuck, and I take about a pound of ground pork. So, like I said, I'm gonna start mixing this up a little bit, get these together. And I'm gonna take 1 cup of onions and 1 cup of celery, put them in. Guys, these were frozen. Pour them in, mix them in a little bit. Now we're gonna take 1 cup of oats. The reason I use oats instead of breadcrumbs is it makes the meatloaf gluten-free. I have a gluten-free person in my household, and we have to watch out for that person. On top of that, I'm going to break 2 eggs. Go ahead and put 2 eggs in it. All right, on top of the eggs, I'm going to put some half and half. I'm not gonna measure, guys. I'm just gonna put a little bit on it. Maybe a quarter cup. Maybe a little more. From there, I'm gonna put some ketchup. All meatloaf recipes don't call for ketchup, but I'm just throwing some in. On top of the ketchup, I'm going to put one of my favorite barbecue sauces, sauces. I'm not going to tell you what kind it is, but it's one of my favorites. That should be plenty. Now I believe I need a little bit of salt and pepper. Let me find the salt and pepper. All right, we're going to put about a half teaspoon of salt. I had to grab the salt with a paper towel because I got my glove on. Not a ton of salt and a good nice fat teaspoon or better of pepper. Lovely. All right guys, now we've got everything in there. I put me another glove on. We're gonna go ahead and mix this all together. This is really nobody's recipe. I think meatloaf is what it is. You just kind of put there what you think. And but I have watched some people on YouTube do this. I think my wife do it. But the difference is we're putting this on the smoker. I'm gonna smoke this meatloaf. Seems pretty wet. All right, I think that's good, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and form it up, give me some saran wrap, form it up, stick it on the tray, and go fire my pit boss up and get ready to smoke this. Stay tuned. All right guys, poured the meatloaf out on my tray here. Got me some saran wrap. I'm trying to form it to where it looks like a meatloaf. Alright guys, I've got the meatloaf out of my tray. I got saran wrap kind of forming it into a loaf. It's a nice big healthy looking meatloaf. Gonna pull this off, voila! That is a good looking meatloaf. It smells good already with all the stuff I've got on it. I hope it tastes good. So, let's take it out to the Pit Boss pellet grill and put it on there. We're gonna set it to 225, let it smoke for about an hour. And then we're probably going to crank the heat up to about 400 to try to get a crust on the outside of it. We're going to take the internal temperature up to 160. Stay tuned. All right, guys. Here's my meatloaf. Pit Boss is almost up to temperature. I'm going to go ahead and put the Pit Boss right there. I got my probe. This is the Pit Boss 1100 Pro. It's got two probes that come with it. I'm going to put that probe right inside the meatloaf, like so. The meatloaf is pretty cold. It's about 42 degrees right now, that meat is. So, one last thing. I'm going to put a little bit of bone-sucking sauce on the top of this thing. It's going to give it some great color. And that should do it. All right, we're going to shut the lid for one solid hour. I've got this thing set at 225. It's a little cold today, so I may put it at 250 for a bit. But one solid hour, and then we're going to check it, and then we're going to crank the heat to about 400. Stay tuned. All right, guys, we're 1 hour in. The pit boss is sitting at 136. I'm fixing to open it and see what it looks like. I may flip it, and then I'm going to turn the heat up to 400 to finish this thing. So let me get this camera down there, and we'll get a good look at it. All right, guys, opening up. Okay, it's looking pretty good. It's definitely cooking. I'm going to go ahead, let me zoom in here a little bit so you can get a good look at this thing. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to look at the back side. You know something, I'm going to leave it right where it's at. I was going to spin it, but I'm going to leave it right where it's at. I'm going to go ahead and turn it up to 400 degrees. And we're going to let this thing get done. Stay tuned. Hey guys, real quick, while this thing is cooking, I want to give a quick shout out to Dan from Home of the Sticks. Dan is a great guy. He loves growing vegetables. Guys, he got some critters on his Home of the Sticks. I think you'll enjoy his channel. Dan's got one of the voices you can't hardly not listen to. It's from down south, of course. And this is something I'm going to start doing, guys, on just about every video. I'm going to start shouting out a person. Some of the people that I watch regular, and some of the people I don't watch regular. I watch a lot of channels. I've got my regular watchers, the ones I watch all the time. Then I've got a bunch that is, you know, I bounce around from one to the other because there's just so many channels. You can't watch every channel, every video. It's just impossible. So guys, go check Dan out from Home and Sticks channel. I'll try and put a link down below so you guys can get to him easily. I think you'll enjoy him, and if you like what you see when you get over there, throw him a subscription, a big thumbs up, let him know that Lead sent you. Alright guys, so the meatloaf at 160 to me did not seem firm enough, so I went ahead and ran it to 170. It does have pork in it, so I wanted to make sure it was done also. This is my first meatloaf. I have never made a meatloaf in my life, so let's open up the lid and see what she looks like. That is a good looking meatloaf. If it tastes as good as it looks, I've done a fine job. I'm going to get it on a tray, another tray, wrap it up, take it in the house, and we'll take a better look at it in the house. Stay tuned. Alright. Pull off the foil. And there she is. I'm going to slice off this end right here. Hopefully we can see this and get to my camera here. Oh yeah. I was concerned about it being done. It's definitely done. Oh yeah. Alright, I'm going to plate it up, guys, and I'll show you what I'm working with in just a minute. Alright guys, that's what I'm working with. Now for the taste test. All right, this is my first meatloaf I have ever made. I've never made meatloaf, and I've seen these guys doing meatloaf, so I figured I would try. Here we go. It's pretty good. Pretty good for my first meatloaf. Kind of fell apart a little bit when I was cutting it, but overall, pretty good. Any comments, questions about this video, please put down below. And if you haven't, subscribe if you could. Let out.